The Scientific Understanding of Vyavasthit Shakti, Part 2.
Even for this record, Dada says that inner intents are arising in the form of saññā or association in the past life. And due to that, paramanu or subatomic particles get charged in the form of code words. Then they become ready in the form of a shorthand in this life. And once you come across an evidentiary instrument, the record starts to play. So what I just spoke now, I didn't even think about what I was going to say. I hadn't even planned it. Yet one by one, the speech keeps on coming out. So even I feel like, oh, what is this record playing? What was charged is what's playing.
So you are certainly not the one speaking.
When we say, I spoke so nicely today, I explained it so nicely to everyone. You all thought my speech was good, didn't you? No one had any issues, right? So that ego is simply expressing egoism. Otherwise, the record is playing with the intent that it was charged with. The only thing is that, due to the link of the Jnani and through his grace, this record starts to become universally accepted. But one of the evidences in that is of the Jnani, his blessings, his spiritual powers, the energy he instills, or the power of his speech. But what is the main point? One's own doership is not there even to the slightest extent. The speech or the thoughts arise due to the scientific circumstantial evidences, even with respect to the body. Its form, color, shape, eyes, hair, that is all exactly in the form of discharge. One does not have to do anything for that. Then in order to explain that, these people discover DNA, hormones, cells, and various other things. But all that has come in the form of an effect due to the causes. Then they will say, the boy looks like his mother, and this girl looks like her father. They just say that casually, but actually, it's all exactly according to one's own karmic account. And it's also possible that the child may look different from their mother or father. They tell me, you look like Dada. No one tells me I look like my parents. That's also something new, isn't it? So these are various kinds of machinery. When the discharge is unfolding, there is no doer of that. One thinks, I will do this and I will do that. But no, that is also Vyavasthit. It's Vyavasthit which has unfolded. The speech coming forth is Vyavasthit. The body is Vyavasthit. And the actions are also Vyavasthit. For the whole day, whatever is experienced through the five senses is all under the control of Vyavasthit. We need to fit this in our understanding that no one is able to do anything. Although, if someone is saying, he did this, he said this to me, and then... It sounds so funny because these are actually spinning tops which are clashing with each other, and the one crying is also a top. They are nothing but tops. He is a top and the other person who is crying is also a top. It's a top that's crying. He did this to me, he hit me like this, then I got knocked down, then I fell this way.
He's crying, but actually you have neither fallen, been knocked down, nor been hit.
You are separate within, and the one within him is also separate. But suffering is arising because one is not able to understand that. So now, we are trying to go in reverse. If suffering arises, then check and ask file 1. You saw him as the doer? Find out how he is not the doer, how the circumstances are the doers, how the whole design is unfolding, how something that's charged gets discharged, how the effects of causes manifest. Set it however you can. But the suffering should go away. And you should get inner closure that, oh, this is how it happened. Why does garvaras, or indulgence in the pleasure that arises from doership, persist? Because at the subtle level, his belief of I am the doer doesn't go away. So when good things happen, then he prevails in the belief that I did it. And when things spoil, then he prevails in the belief that the other person did it. So whenever the work spoils, then he immediately finds out, who spoiled it, who spoiled it, who spoiled it. And if things go well, then he'll say, this is how I did it, this is how I did it, this is how I did it. At that time, when the work spoils, one should see everything as an evidentiary doer and set the understanding that Vyavasthit is the doer. When the work goes well, then also one should see everything as an evidentiary doer and that Vyavasthit is the doer. And it is exact. By exact, we mean the more one can see the circumstances, the evidentiary instruments, time and location as not being an independent doer, that this result has come after the coming together of all these circumstances, then the suffering will go away by that much. and the pure vision to see the pure soul will remain within. Or else, where one used to see the faults of others, he will now see the other person as completely faultless. And on the other hand, the more one sees that the doership is of scientific circumstantial evidences, that much of his garvaras will also go away. So based on the result, one should apply the jagrati or awakened awareness. Why did this suffering arise? It's because I missed to apply the agnas. So apply the agna of Vyavasthita exactly. And really, one should perfect each agna. Okay, let me stay in the applied awareness of the pure soul for 1 or 2 days. Then find all the literature of Dada regarding that and study what Dada is trying to say about it. What does it mean to see the pure soul? We are going to discuss that topic this time around. Seeing the pure soul, clearing falls with equanimity, the agna of Vyavasthita. And today we are discussing that. But one should put this into practice. For a day or two, just practice the applied awareness of the pure soul. Then for a day or two, just practice the agna of Vyavasthita. Then for a day or two, just practice the agna of clearing falls with equanimity. And we are already going to satsang on Sundays. Or spend 2 hours on it. The one in whom interference keeps arising, he should just decide that, from the time I leave the hall today until I come back, whatever I see outside, I want to see it all as scientific circumstantial evidences. Then even if the intellect arises within, I don't want to listen to it. I want to understand Vyavasthita today. Dada used to say to do an experiment for that. Spend a Sunday letting go of the reins. Let go of the reins. What are the reins? Just as a rider grabs the reins of the horse, and if he wants it to go left, then he'll pull the reins to that side. And if he wants to go to the right, then he'll pull the reins to that side. If he wants it to go slower, then he'll loosen his grip a little. And if he wants it to go fast, then he'll do this. He has his techniques. Similarly, you should let go of the reins once. Take them off and put them aside. Now let the horse take you wherever it wants to. And that horse will not throw you off. It will drop you off all the way to your house, to your original state as a self. Similarly, Dada says to let go of the reins of the mind, speech, body, 5 senses, intellect, chit, and ego for 1 day. Then you will practically experience, am I doing this or am I getting everything without doing anything? It will then come into your experience that whatever is happening due to scientific circumstantial evidences. It's happening without me doing anything. And the work is not being completed because some evidences are lacking. And that's why it's not being completed. And the work that completed was because all the evidences came together for it. And that's why it was completed. If you are not able to sleep, then it means some evidences are lacking. As long as the evidences are lacking, you will not be able to sleep. Once the evidences come together, you'll fall asleep. You might be feeling a little warm, or you might move your blanket around, or this or that. And if the fan is switched on and you get the evidence of cold air, you will fall asleep right then. So it is only when the scientific circumstantial evidences come together that the activity occurs. If they don't come together, then the activity won't occur. We definitely can't do anything. Humans definitely can't do anything. They simply believe that I did it, which is the part that binds karma for the next life. Otherwise, one is not able to do anything during discharge. And Dada says, we have experienced this. And that's why we are able to see the world as flawless. So every single concept of Dada's, to understand the original science of Vyavasthita, Dada has revealed such a variety of matter, we just need to put that into practice. Practice means to use it. For example, if you have a recipe to make a dessert, then will it be enough if you simply get the recipe book, read it, and put it away? Someone will ask, do you know how to make it? You'll reply, of course I know. Then he will ask, okay, tell me how. You'll say, first take this, then take that, then dip it in the syrup, and then eat it. He will then ask, but have you ever made it? You'll say, no, I haven't. Then he'll reply, what's the point of describing it? It's already written in the book. So can you say that you have learned it if you have simply memorized what's written? What does practice mean? One should have spent an hour or two for it. So in this satsang, if the satsang was at 10 o'clock, then the hour before, from 9 to 10, we should see what is happening within. It may arise from within. You shouldn't have done that. Why did you put it in the front? You should put it in the back so there's more space on the floor. Do this. We should see everything that arises within and ask file 1, are you doing this or is it Vyavasthita? And then if you look at 10 o'clock, then you'll realize that, oh, everything is set in place. So it means everything would have been set in place even if you were absent one day. He would be setting it up every day and saying, put it in the front, place it under this, move this aside, do this, do that. The kids shouldn't sit on the side. The elderly should sit on that side. He would have made everyone set things in place for 2 days. Then on the third day, we should tell file one, be absent today and let's see if things work out or not. And then if we look, then everyone would have sat down and the satsang would have also started. At that time, file one may strongly feel that, we'll see what happens if I'm not around today. Then he would see and realize, oh, everyone has sat down quietly. There's a story of a man who owned a rooster, and he had the illusion that the morning comes only because my rooster crows. He took his rooster to another town. Then when he came back on the third day, he asked the people, did the morning come for you? They replied, yes. He said, oh, really? He was so shocked and thought, how can this be possible? My rooster was in another town and the morning still came in this town. So then how could the morning have come here as well? The morning comes only if the rooster crows, right? Or does the rooster crow if the morning comes? But he had the illusion that the morning comes only because my rooster crows. So he said, I'll make the people of this town miserable by taking my rooster and going away for one day. Then the morning will not come for them and they will all be miserable. Like that, the ego of humans have increased so much. He will say, I'm running this household. And the wife will feel, I'm controlling my husband. I'm taking care of the kitchen. I'm managing the money. And he just wastes it, but I take care of everything. But when we're away, that's when we realize that this world was already running, is running, and will be running. It's due to our illusion. There is a verse describing how the dog feels that he is the one carrying the load of the cart. For example, if an ox is pulling a cart and a dog is stuck under it, actually at first, because of the heat, the dog would have gone under the cart for some shade to sleep in. And then once the cart moves, then the dog gets scared and feels, oh, it moved. Then as the cart moves more, the dog moves with it for some shade and feels, oh, I am driving this. Then it will start walking with a lot of pride and with its tail sticking up. Because the dog went from this human life to a dog, that habit of doership isn't going away. The habit of I am the doer, I am the doer. But who is actually pulling the cart and who is believing that I am pulling it? It happens on its own, and due to illusion, one believes that I did it, I did it, I did it. Really, he isn't able to do anything. And he even becomes really sad about not being able to do anything. But that's what you should actually be happy about. Dada used to say, if someone's taken our nyan and he doesn't know how to do anything in worldly interactions, then he will end up reaching the state of a nyani. He would automatically become a nyani. Someone like me, he would become a nyani without doing anything. Because I didn't know how to do anything, and I had received the state of I am pure soul, I am pure soul. So then I was given this seat. It came on its own. So it's like that. The more this doership leaves, the more this nyan comes into experience. The entire self will come into experience. And that is why these experiments need to be set. The experiments of how is he the non-doer? How is he faultless? How are circumstances doing things? How is this discharge? How is this experiment being conducted? And how is the scientist as a knower separate from it? The chemicals and catalysts in the experiment are being added and removed, and the results are coming about. But one is the knower, one is not the doer. And whatever this body is doing today is also based on what was charged in the past life, and it's being discharged in the form of a scientist today. But the self is definitely not the doer, and a scientist is also not able to perform an experiment independently. The experiment takes place when so many evidences come together. So we need to set this understanding in every single way. You'll say, I've cooked a meal made of very nice curry and fried spices, but we should ask file one, was it made because of the chickpea flour or the buttermilk, or was salt also needed? You even need someone who will eat it. You need pots, tongs, spices, oil, you need so many things. It's in Dada's talks. Dada says, these people use so many things that if you make a list, it can be compiled into a scripture. So much. One assumes, one believes that I am the doer. But the action occurs after so many circumstances come together. Really, he is not able to do anything. So wherever we see someone's doership, we don't actually see someone's doership, but we see their faults. Why is he doing that? He doesn't let me do it. He only wants to do things according to his own will. He speaks so recklessly. He does whatever he wants. He doesn't understand. He doesn't know how to do it. The more we see someone else's faults, We should understand that we are not seeing them as a pure soul and as a non-doer. And we are indeed seeing the Prakriti or non-self complex as the doer. And actually, the Prakriti is also not the doer. In the discharge, the Prakriti is also not the doer. The Prakriti cannot say that I am the doer. It is also discharge. And the ego also cannot say that I am the doer, because the ego just believes that I am the doer, but it is not the doer, and the self is truly not the doer. So wherever we see others at fault, decide that they are not the doer. Apply that Vyavasthit is the doer. We want to take this word of Vyavasthit to the level of experience. We don't want to just make use of the word. We want to take the word to the level of experience through understanding. And wherever you feel the pleasure of, I did it, look how nicely I did things, then even there, the experience, by doing a lot of analysis of, why did this result of garvaras arise? It's because there is some form of doership arising somewhere within me. Analyze how I am not the doer and how this ends up happening. The most important part is analyzing how this ends up happening. How does this speech come out? If we know the exact links from the causes to the effects, then the ego of I am the doer or I spoke has to go away. The ego of I am the one who spoke, who else would be saying this, remains only because the ignorance of the self is there. But as one sees that the things occurring are occurring due to these circumstances, then when one sees that exactly, then the ego melts away. So that is the stage we wish to go to. Instead of having the intent of I want to get rid of the ego, I want to cut it off, I want to destroy it, we want to have the intent to destroy the beliefs arising from ignorance. We want to destroy the misunderstanding, then that will destroy the ego on its own. And the understanding we are trying to fit is, how is everything happening? How is everything happening? If one person is making the determination to practice celibacy, even then, Dada says that we must have charged that determination, and that is why it's discharging today. It's such a subtle discovery of how things are happening. In every single matter, there is a detailed discovery of how things are happening. Why did the husband quarrel with the wife? Well, it was because of these causes that this occurred. If there is tremendous amount of weakness, then a great amount of agitation occurs. That is Dada's discovery. And on the other hand, the pure soul is a non-doer, and the pure soul of the other person is also a non-doer. It's due to this attraction that the result of repulsion has come about at the end. If there is excessive attraction, then excessive repulsion will occur. But this discovery, Dada's whole discovery of how the self is not the doer and how Vyavasthit is the doer, the question that person was asking yesterday, what did Dada see when he attained Jnana? This is what he saw. He saw that, on what basis is the world running? In the two parts of Aptavani 11, Dada has provided so many subtle distinctions on how this world is running. There is a whole Aptavani on Vyavasthit. And some talks related to that can also be found in other books, in the Apta Sutras and other books as well. Dada has studied this in such great detail, and it prevails in him so much that even if someone were to accuse him, or any type of, there were even people who would tell Dada, someone should shoot you. Even then, Dada never felt, why is he saying this? Even if the other person was right in front of him. Why? Because Dada had the experience of Jnana that, no, you are a pure soul and this is your discharge. Who is he going to kill? How can he kill me? He doesn't even have the strength to go to the toilet, so then what is he going to do? It used to remain in his experience to that extent. And that is what we are trying to learn. Gradually apply this in your day-to-day life. Start with a small occasion. Start with the smallest occasion. If you want to brush your teeth in the morning, then you should see, did I brush or did someone else do it? Why didn't I brush today? Because there was no water today, so I couldn't brush. There was a leakage in the sink and the water was spilling on the floor, so then I didn't brush. Then I went to the bathroom and brushed there. So the space changed, the time changed, circumstances and the evidentiary instruments changed. How many things are needed to simply brush your teeth? A napkin is needed, a brush is needed, toothpaste is needed, a tongue cleaner is needed, and it also has to be morning time. If he was awake the whole night, then he wouldn't even brush in the morning. He'd drink tea straight away in the morning. So he also would have needed to sleep at night. See a small occasion in great detail. And he would also be brushing in different ways. Everyone would have different techniques because it depends on how the top is discharging. So we should see that it's the discharge that's doing it. We are not the doers. Some waste so much water and others only use a few drops to wash their face. We'd say, you have soap on your face, at least wash that off. And he'd say, I'll just wipe it off. anger, pride, deceit, and greed would be playing a role there. Someone's pride may be playing a role. Someone's greed may be playing a role. Someone may have a lot of exactness, or someone may keep things dirty. See what these prakritis are like. It is discharging the way it was charged. And then they help him understand and teach him moral values of, this is how you should brush. Those are all the moral values which one teaches to another. By giving moral values, it actually just means that we are providing water and soil to the seed, but the fruit will end up coming out from the seed itself. If the leaves are rotten, if the seed is rotten, then each leaf will also be rotten. And if it is a healthy seed, then its leaves will come out healthy. They would say, I've taught this kid repeatedly, but still, he's just so spoiled. He doesn't listen, he doesn't know. But no, it's not like that. If the seed was rotten, then the fruit will also be rotten. But it should still be in our worldly interactions to keep helping him understand and keep talking to him. We should recognize his prakriti and then get the work done. But the worldly interactions which we need to do, for every single occasion, like dealing with the kids, dealing with the wife, dealing with the husband, our work, or handling the kitchen, see every single small occasion in this matter. How is Vyavasthit Shakti running all this? It is not our doership. And as we start to practice it, the level of experience starts to increase from applying it in small occasions, and then we are even able to apply it in big occasions. For me, the experience started to fit together from small occasions. And now, by doing that, whatever big occasions come, the jnana immediately remains that, oh, this is Vyavasthit, it can't touch me. Vyavasthit can't touch us. Vyavasthit means, who does this whole chain of Vyavasthit affect? It affects Deepak. The mind, speech, body, intellect, chit, ego, and all the external evidences come together and they can affect Deepak. Vyavasthit is within the entire link of discharge. The self is separate from that. The self is 100% separate from that. And as one practices that, or grasps and applies Dada's Nyan sentences repeatedly, like, this is what Vyavasthit is, this is what Vyavasthit is, this is what Vyavasthit is, by gradually acquiring every single bead of experience, when the entire necklace of beads is formed, then that is called experienced Nyan. Then it prevails in him. He doesn't need to use the Nyan, but it prevails on its own. Even then, if some sort of suffering arises, then he will feel, why did this arise? Then the analysis starts back up again, and his vision changes. And once he applies the Nyan exactly, he feels free from uneasiness and agitation. Without changing the people or things on the outside, the effect within changes. Why? Because my understanding changed. So by repeatedly practicing Vyavasthit as a whole, actually, we need to perfect the five agnas in this life. 70%, 80%, 90%, and when it reaches 100%, then that will be our absolute state. That is the real spiritual effort we need to make in this life. Set this whenever you're free, Vyavasthit. Today we are discussing the topic of Vyavasthit, and in the evening we'll discuss clearing files with equanimity, then we'll talk about the pure soul. So develop this understanding. How is this Vyavasthit? It's not just about reading the book. Read the whole book once, but after that, read one page and stop and think. Read it as if you are studying. Dada's first sentence in the book is, do you run the store? Do you run the store or do the customers come to buy goods? Do you call them or do they come on their own? There is so much description. The questions and answers that Dada has provided, that itself unveils so much understanding for us. We will study every single question and understand what was asked, what was Dada's answer. If we study that, then we'll feel, oh, what must be prevailing within Dada? What did he see Vyavasthit as? What must he have seen? That is the real spiritual effort we need to make to see and understand it. And as that starts to fit within us, and we start to understand it, then this worldly life will not affect us or obstruct us. It won't become the source of our misery. We will be able to remain completely separate as a self, despite having a physical body in this worldly life. We will be able to remain in a liberated state. So there is a lot of talk about Vyavasthit. We just need to study it now. Because we've already heard a lot about it in the form of words. We are trying to put it into practice now. Apply it practically. And as one understands Vyavasthit more, then he won't feel the need to ask for explanations from the other person, like, tell me why this happened. He would already have closure and inner satisfaction. The other person would give us closure and inner satisfaction, and we would believe him, and then we would feel at peace. There is no need for all that. There is no need for an arbitrator or a judge or anyone to give us an explanation, because closure and inner satisfaction would prevail within us in every situation. And if we don't have closure and inner satisfaction, then it means we missed applying the Agna of Avestit, because we saw someone as a doer or at fault. So we need to find solutions like this. This resultant state that is free of uneasiness and agitation should continuously remain within us. And if something is disturbing that state, then it means that we are missing something. So by checking exactly and resetting the Nyan, then the result will come. Dada says it nicely and exactly in one place. He says, we are the pure soul, and our real form is only as the knower-seer. And we are applying these five agnas to attain that state. If we were walking here while seeing the pure soul in others, and then a thought came in between, then we should immediately feel that this is discharge and it's vevastit, clear it with equanimity. After clearing it, come back to the state of seeing others as a pure soul. So these five agnas are for us to continuously remain as a knower-seer. The state of knower-seer is our original form. But how can we continuously remain in our state if we are busy and entangled in the worldly interactions? If we keep the vision of the five agnas in between, then that will continue to make us as the knower-seer. If someone insults us, then we should instantly feel that this is a file that has arisen. Let's clear it with equanimity. Did he do it? No, it was Vevastit that did it. Who did Vevastit insult? It insulted the relative. So then we will be able to come into the self. Every single word of the five agnas is such that it keeps us in the self. The fifth agna says to remain in satsang and to remain in the five agnas. So it is also pushing us towards the agnas. Reading Dada's speech will also push us towards that, because we continue to get understanding on how to remain in the five agnas. So to become the form of the self, or to become the knower-seer, is the main point for us. It is what we want to attain, and the five agnas are in the form of protection for attaining that. And we are having this satsang to understand that in detail.